Welcome back, guys, to the channel. I'm Grumpy Panda. Welcome back to the Saw playthrough, and we are about to see what Jigsaw's got in store for us. We are actually about to save another person who is really a fanatic when it comes to Jigsaw himself. He actually wants to be tested, believe it or not. Most people go through these tests not wanting to be tested. This guy has been waiting for this his entire life. He's actually obsessed with Jigsaw. So I don't know how this is gonna play out. I think he's right up ahead. Let's get into it. Here we go. Locate the crematorium and locate Obi's trap. I think it's Obi is his name. As in Obi-Wan Kenobi. All right. Stop watching me. Meow. Where are you? Okay, acquire the frozen hand. Oh, there's a trap right here. I didn't even see it. Didn't. I pressed A. Did I trap? I pressed A to disarm it. Maybe, I was gonna say maybe I trapped it, but it wouldn't have shown it had it not been trapped. So that's really odd, but we just got the checkpoint, so it's not a big deal, but I find it odd. Maybe there are two traps. I don't know. That looks like a line to me. Maybe I didn't disarm it like I thought. Oh, I see what I did. I did trap it. I trapped it myself. It looks like, I think that's, that line looks, it's a berserker. But yeah, so I trapped it. I understand. So we're gonna have to kill this guy. How many health? We got two health items. Crematorium. The Whitehurst Crematorium oven is state-of-the-art in every way. The oven's heated to 870 to 980 degrees Celsius to ensure that the most organic matter is vaporized. The body is stripped of any jewelry, metals, but why would someone want to be cremated with their jewelry intact? Like, I know people get, like, I'm going to talk about this here in a second. It's just me. The body is stripped of any jewelry, metals, before being inserted. Oh, I see. Before being inserted into the main chamber called, I thought they did it with it on. Retort, please note that the burning more than one body at a time is illegal in this country. Yeah, because nobody would ever want to get done things done efficiently or things done faster. They would never cut corners. Though this is generally unenforceable law. Yeah, because how are you going to know? The matter that remains is usually small bone fragments, and those are processed in a grinder called a cremulator. I don't know if that's true or not, but it sounds viable. Like, how do, I mean, I don't know if bones get completely incinerated in you know what I mean? These are the remains that are given to the families or, in the case of the Ward's estate, dispersed. Okay. You know what some people are doing? Have you heard about this? Two things here. Number one, when your loved ones die, they're taking either bones from, I don't know what bones, like maybe their hands and some kind of bones, and they're making either rings out of it or like making a necklace out of like their bones, and it looks really pretty or something like that. Have you guys heard about that? I've seen it be done. It's kind of crazy. I remember my mom one time said that she had a lovely little Chico, or a lovely little Chihuahua. I brought him on stream a few times, I think. Not Mia, Chico. And Chico was a lovely little Chihuahua, and at the time, he wasn't in the greatest of health. Well, he was old already, but he wasn't, you know, in bad health. But she was thinking, you know, if he was to pass away, why not, you know, people at the time were starting to get their dogs. It's mainly dogs. You can't do it with the people, as far as I know. But they would, like, once they died, they would basically get them stuffed and made into a statue. And my mom's like, what if I was to do that with Chico? That way we could always, you know, remember him or something like that. And I'm like, that's crazy, Mom. Why would you want to do that? That would, like, dishonor the dog itself because, you know, I mean, the spirit's gone. There's nothing. It's a statue. Why would that be creepy as hell? Do not do that, Mom. And so finally, she really wasn't thinking too hard about it. She just loved the dog so much that she really didn't want to think about him dying, and be her, she'd be without him. So, but anyways, my mom did think about that for a short period of time. Yes, you're correct. I'm so sorry. It's not the bones, it's the ashes. It's actually part of the ashes, and they make it into a necklace. I apologize. I misspoke. It's definitely the ashes, I think, not the bones. I was thinking of something like that, but I did hear about it. And I've seen it be done, but they use the ashes, I think, not the bones. Which I'm sure they can use the bones too. But the other thing I was going to say is, you know, people, like, they usually don't get cremated with their stuff because that kind of beats the purpose of, you know, why would you want to get your necklace cremated? Makes no sense. But people, especially old, back in the olden days with the Egyptians, they believe that you could take it, you know, the old saying, you can't take it with you when you die. That came from the Egyptians. People would be buried with gold and stuff. Well, the thing about that is, you know, that's crazy, because why the hell would you want to go get buried with a bunch of treasure and gold and stuff? You know, that's, to me, not only is it kind of silly to do it, number one, number two, if people know that you have stuff in your coffin, they're more likely to break in and crypt steal you. Is that what it's called? Crypt stealing? No, grave rob. I'm sorry. They're going to grave rob you and dishonor your gravesite, which is something nobody wants to have done. So it's just, you know, basically two really good reasons not to do it. You know, let your loved ones who you left behind have that money and let them use it. I see no reason to bury to get buried with your money or, what's the word? I see no reason to get buried with your money or your jewelry or any material. What's it called? I can't think. I'm having a brain fart here. Your valuables. Okay. I see no reason to get, you know, for you to get buried with your valuables or money or anything that would be really important to you. Unless it was like something like, there's a couple of special cases, I guess, that circumstance that would, you know, maybe something like that, like something very, very special. But other than that, keep your money, you know, don't get buried with it. That's just my opinion, though, but you can do what you want. I don't think it's a very, people don't use that custom. That custom's not used very often anymore, I don't think. As far as I know, but people used to do it all the time back in the day. Wait a second. Has to be this way, yeah. Okay, where are we at on the map? I see. We got three. We gotta acquire the frozen hand. Yeah. It's like, you know, special items like a locket or like something that shares the bond of your friendship with somebody or something like that. You know, you can, you know, let them, you know, if it's not gonna do you any good, but the truth, or, you know, why not keep it? Why not keep that ring or locket, you know, the person that you knew him by? That's just my opinion. And, like, pass it down to your grandkids or something. I don't know. Like, once you're dead and gone, no one's going to know that locket, you know. That it's not going to have any place in the world at that point. So you're just burying something, you know what I mean? I would, when I get old one day, I'm going to give all my good shit to my grandkids and stuff like that and let them use it, you know. Like, I would totally, if I was a wife or something like that, an old ass lady, I would take my ring that I was married with and give it to somebody and let them use it as a ring, because there's no reason to, you know what I mean? There's no reason to keep that ring. Give it to somebody, let them use it. Let them get divorced. I'm just kidding. It's a joke. But that's just the way I feel. Like, I mean, when people have beautiful jewelry like that, let them use it, man. There's no reason to keep that shit. Okay, there have been significant losses of John Doe's. Have we read this? Okay, no, we haven't. Due to the extensive experimental treatments, and we don't have the storage room in the morgue to wait for the local crematorium to retrieve and process the bodies. To be frank, the corpses are piling up faster than we can get rid of them. I recommend we build a crematorium in the building. This would save us plenty of money over what the local crematorium is charging us, and would give us the capacity to process the bodies. Never thought about that. Yep. When a person dies, they pretty much die twice. Once for when they really die, and the second time is when they are forgotten in the world and nobody knows who they are, and they didn't, you know, that is kind of, I'm going to be honest with you guys, like, would I like to do something really, really important in the world to be remembered by? Yeah, I kind of would. Do I have to be famous? No, but I don't know, like, it would kind of suck not to, like, leave either a piece of you or people know who you are, you know, and, you know, be forgotten. It kind of sucks, you know, to me that does. Other people could care less, you know, but I would like to be able to be remembered by doing something really good, not being notorious about, like, doing something really bad, but something that would bring joy to people's lives or something, you know? Be remembered by something good, even if it is as small as having a small community on Twitch. You know, I'm okay with that. Okay, so we had a fuse there, but they die twice. Once for when they die, and the second time for when they're forgotten. I've heard that before, though. All right, another trap. Oh, we got a work table. Nice. Got some. Oh, I might use these actually. Alright, let's get the stun trap because. Well. What do we got? We got the explosives. Okay, let's use stun trap. Well, we need more ammonia, I think, is what it is. Or. Got a fuse. And that's another reason, I just thought of this, that's another reason why I would be an organ donor. Hell, if I die, chances are, like, my grandfather had a terrible heart. He had great, no wait, one of them had terrible lungs, the other one had a terrible heart, you know. It just takes one body part to mess up for you to die, obviously, so you can have a, you know, clean bill of health, but then if your heart gives out on you and craps out and you don't get another one, you're done for. So, you know, be an organ donor, you know, and if I can help a few people live or extend their lives, hey, I'm all for it, man. I don't see why people wouldn't be an organ donor, to be honest with you. The only bad thing about being an organ donor is if you were to die or almost die, they have to process your body really fast. Because once you're dead or about to die, they pretty much need to they need to do surgery to get all your organs out and process them, get them on ice, so they can, like, basically keep them ready for the person who needs them, which chances are there's somebody already on a waiting list needing your kidney/heart/liver, whatever. So, like, they're not just going to put it on ice and leave it in the fridge somewhere or whatever. They're using it. They already have a list. And once somebody dies on a highway or something, on a pile, I-59, you know, wreck, like, those people who died, they already know where they're going. They're pretty efficient with that kind of stuff because they have to be. So, that would be the only bad thing about being an organ donor is, like, you know, You just died and your family's outside and it's like, hey, we kind of need to, you know, get your body. So say goodbye to your so-and-so, say goodbye to so-and-so. We need to, like, process them, you know, or something like that. That would kind of suck for the grieving aspect of it, but it's still going for a good cause. Like, if I'm dead, whatever, man, I don't care. Use my body parts. No, that's really, I didn't think about that, but, you know, if you were organ, it's not like they're gonna pull up your license and say, oh, this guy right here is an organ donor. We're gonna like, you know, give him the old special treatment. You know what I'm saying? Wink, wink. No, they're, number one, they're doctors. They want to save lives. Number two, if you're thinking of it from just the standpoint of liability issues, like if they keep having people die on them like that during surgery and stuff, it's not looking good for people, you know, for business, because hospitals are a business. They're private owned organizations. And, you know, insurance comes into play. They get sued all the time. It's just, you know, just think of it that way. They get sued all the time, really. That'd be really bad for them. That's interesting. Let's work backwards on this one. So far this is pretty accurate. Nope, that's not it. I think this is right. Really? We gotta get this moving somehow. Hold on. Ah, there it is. Sometimes it looks like it doesn't fit. Oh, we've already got that schematic though. Oh well, we worked for it. That's the second time we found it, I think. I think that's the last schematic we can get. There's three schematics we got. Okay. Let's get you, Jigsaw. You're mine, buddy. I have no idea how long this game is either. It's been a pretty good playthrough already at this point. And this is our sixth victim. No, fifth maybe? I forget. So it's... We have definitely came a long way. We've already been in here. I forgot where we was at. I need to take some Zyrtec. Okay, I see the objective right there. X marks a spot. Alright, we'll have to kill this fella. Is he blind? Oh yeah, he's just like the other guy. He can hear, but he can't see. I want to do an explosive trap. Was I supposed to save him? Or was, I mean... I'm confused because he was going to try to kill me regardless, so I'm just trying to figure that one out. Okay, why is there a weapons case and it's asking for a gear, yet there's nothing inside it? It's kind of odd. Wouldn't you say? Okay, so why X marks the spot? Is it like here? I think he's saying it's here, maybe. Oh, I just dropped a weapon. Let's try punching through like we always do. If you can't figure it out with your brain and solving the problem that way, use your fists. Punch through the wall. Works for me all the time. And look where it's gotten me. There's the X right there, I see it. There's a shotgun, which means that's a trap. Let's see if... Wait, is it armed already? I saw... Oh, there it is. Oh. Nope. Let's look for a guy, and if a guy comes, we can just arm that one. Like, you get more shotgun shells than anything else in this game. See? Told you. I hear somebody, damn it. That bothers me. Is that another shotgun? I don't like hearing footsteps and not knowing where they're at. Oh dear. Things are getting really interesting now. He's pulled out the big guns, hasn't he, guys? When he's got twirling, you know, torpedo things on the ground, ready to cut, slice, and dice you. Reducing fluids. We have found interesting results regarding treatment using fluids to generate a patient's mental status in our initial tests. We found patients much more at ease after drawing 40 ounces of blood. We have expanded these tests to see if patients will become calmer after dehydration, removal of the prostate, removal of the salivary glands, and so on. Damn, that's just inhumane, dude. Like, Jesus. Crazy. All right, let's go back to the X. I don't know. Okay, where was that X at? I saw it earlier. It was over here, wasn't it? Do you see a way to get in? Oh, we've got to punch through that wall is what it is. I saw the wall where we had to punch through it. Okay, perfect. All right, let's test our metal here. See what we're made of. Run! You guys want me to die in there? I kind of want to die in there and see what happens. Just see the animation of me dying. If I see a checkpoint, I'll do it. Now, what I say about your problems? If you can't solve it with this, use this. Ah! Hulk smash! No, get back. Get back your gun. I want the gun. What's that? Hulk smash! I just feel at ease with this gun because I'm a cop, I guess. Okay, guys. Now, on the second, on Thursday, we're going to have Zumba class. And on the next day, we're going to have yoga. Now, is everyone completely ready and not confused about our scheduling, okay? I know we've been having yoga on Tuesdays, but that's when spin class is happening, okay? We do not do spin on Tuesdays anymore, okay? Everyone pay attention. This is very important. yeah, we got a calendar. We got to stick to it. Oh, there's a metal hand. Or is that the hand we'll... Acquire the frozen hand. I don't know if that... X marks the spot. Oh, okay. Wait. Shoot. Let me check something. Maybe I do have to go... I mean, I know I have to go down, but... Let me try punching the wall really fast. Because that's what my life's consisting of. Oh! Nah, it ain't gonna work. It's too strong. Get your weapon. Get your weapon. Oh God. Chemical warfare. Not good. One button. Soundtrap. Hey, buddy. Appreciate it. The scissors should be one. Oh. But there's two of them. Alright, a surgeon's hand holds the key to life. Huh? Checkpoint.
Even in death, the hand will not relinquish the key. You don't have time for it to throw.
We're gonna find the thing.
I suggest you find a more extreme method.
Incineration. The what we just talked about and read on. Even though what's it called? The machine's called the cremator. Wait. I guess it's called the crematory. I said the cremator. To me, that's funny. Get me out of this thing. Where's he at? Where are you? We have to go back upstairs, I'm pretty sure. Let's see if he comes in here. I actually want him to. And if he does, I'll blow his head off. Letter from Pam Jenkins. Oswald, if you want to play hardball, then go right ahead. You didn't think I would take precautions? There was a reason we went back to your place. I took your notes and sent them to my pub. Oh, shoot. I took your notes and sent them to the publisher. It's all on the record now, baby. Good luck getting your book written without your source material. Oh, and if you try to show this to a judge, I will deny writing it. I mean, who are they going to believe? A scumbag like you or a respected author like me? Get cancer, die, you poor, you bastard. Pam Jenkins. Damn, she played him. Well, there's a reason why she had sex with him then. It wasn't because Stone Cold Joe Rogan's a stud, which he is. It's because that. Really, there's nothing in the med kit thing? I haven't found a needle in forever. I'm starting to get worried. I'm going to start itching and getting hives and jonesing for a needle because I can't find one. We actually still got two though. No, I messed up. Did it on purpose the second time. First time I didn't. But I messed up and I keep forgetting that it's A. I'm pressing RT, which releases that trap. I couldn't do it for the longest time. I didn't know how to do it. But now that I know how to, I'm releasing them every time instead of shooting. Oh, wow. I'm so happy that I found that. I'm so happy. I'm so happy. Yes, sirree. I'm happy as I can be. Yeah. So we actually missed the needle. Let's go ahead and. Oh, I didn't mean to drop it. I'm sorry. Let's go ahead and. Good news, guys, I can pick up those scissors now. So that's actually a good thing, because now I can not have to worry about toting that revolver around anymore. But this is a one-shot right here. It Should be a one shot at least. Just like a scalpel. It's a scalpel. Isn't this the same area? Yeah, it is. So now that we gotta locate the crematorium and Obi's trap. Okay. Well, we're definitely going the right way. At least we know we are going the right way. Because the door just shut on us. Oh, is there another? Oh, I was hoping there's another needle in there, man. Been awesome. Excellent. Whoa, what happened to this guy? My man got pinned up. Chained up like Pinhead did. It looked like Pinhead got a hold of him, honestly. At least he's watching some TV. Don't forget to watch my channel, buddy. I'd appreciate it. You demand. Now, watch me while I punch through the walls! Like this. Like this. Yeah. My hand. Hulk smash! What's in here? Another gun. Yay! Give me a gear. Somebody give me a gear. You got a gear? Come on, give me a gear. We'll find one. Hopefully. Pig! Come back!
Get out. What are the rules?
Did you think your test was going to be that easy?
No, I didn't mean to offend.
There are people here that are more interested in finding me than freeing you. Can you convince them that your life is worth saving?
Ooh.
This isn't what I wanted.
Wait, what? I'm confused, like, what did he mean by that? Oh, we gotta find a gear, guys. I want the gun. Give me the gun. I want the gun. No, please. You got a gear? Come on, give me a gear. Please. Pretty please. I can't find a gear. That's okay. I like that. So that basically revealed that Jigsaw is the pig. It's not like another Amanda Young or anything like that. Just wanted to make sure of that. This thing's probably about to close on me. I'm sure of it. That looks like something right there too. Ah! Dang. No gun. Missed out on the gear, man. Oh, I was like, what is that? Well, into the abyss we go. Checkpoint.
Never enough time.
Guess that's the door. Okay, so what we'll do is go to that one first. No big deal. Not a big deal.
You appreciate life. You must enjoy each breath.
Oh, I enjoy it. Actually, thank you. Yeah, take the first one. Let's try this bad boy out then. I don't even remember seeing that one, but okay. I didn't see this one top right, but it's there. Okay. That one doesn't need to be connected now, but it's there. There. That one's there. I'm doing a way better job already. Ah, shit. We can't leave this one in the corner, though. Hold up. Let me think. Okay, so... That one's gotta be like that. Got it. We got this one. This one's kinda easy now. I won't say easy, but it's kinda there. We're missing one goddamn light. One light? No way, man. To move it. See what I did there? I had to like keep moving the pieces around right there. All right, let's go. I don't know how much time we got. 2:30, so truthfully, I just want to get, I don't want to do that again, so. Sure, this is like the ultimate test or something. Eek.
Come here, cop. I want that key.
No, wrong button. It has to be because this shit's hard now. Disappointed myself for that. I really did, like a...
To appreciate life, you must enjoy.
Oh wow, that's actually really funny now. What the dial pad's for. For the big boys. Yeah, we'll do the same way as before. We'll start from the right. Where's it at? Wait. Excellent. That one was not easy. Let's kill this guy now. Let's do stun trap.
Aggression has its price, detective.
Activate the circuit boxes. Okay, we did that. Alright, activate the two circuit boxes that open the door. I think it gave you a choice whether or not you wanted to do the pipe dial or not. What the fuck is that? What is that? I gotta know. Ain't no telling what's over there, man. I kind of want to see what it is. I know I'm... All right, so our objectives now still are to locate Obi's trap and the crematorium. All right, let's go. We should not... It seems like we're very close to the end. But I could be wrong. I don't know. Ooh. What's that? What's that? Ooh-wee. Crematorium stage left. Okay. Do you see me, Jigsaw? I'm coming for you. He's probably going to put a trap on me. I'll put a spell on him. Where are you? Do I have any more, I dropped the Nelbat. Do I have any more? I used one of my stun trap. All I have now is the explosive trap. I bet I could have made another trap had I gone back, because I think there's a work table back there. Alright. Is that a gas mask? Kind of looks like one. Yeah, it is one. Audio tape. Let's hear the audio tape. Don't know if that's the guy that was wanting to be trapped or not. I didn't get a very good look at the guy before. Alright, here we go. He's walked a mile in our shoes, huh? Place the frozen hand into the furnace. Alright, we're gonna be able to melt it and melt it down. Burn, baby, burn. Fred Krueger, Mom! It was Fred Krueger all along.
Hey, bitch. It wasn't me.
Ashpile, the crematorium key. It was Fred Krueger, Mom. Alright. Alright, this is a puzzle. You got three, not one, but three pipe puzzles. Hello, Obi-Wan.
You have isolated yourself from society.
This guy wanted to be tested. What a maniac.
That you have come to me for your test. For a reason to live. You wish to become like me. But the only way to give others the chance to live life is to understand why it is so precious. The room you are in is attached to a large furnace. Detective Tap.
Being burned alive, man. On a fate I would want.
If he fails, the temperature will increase, and the liquid within your body will boil you alive. Time is short.
Time is short. Here we go. Three of them. Bam, bam, bam. The first one's easy if I can remember how to do it.
No, this is my game.
It was supposed to be his game, though. There it is. There we go. That first one's pretty easy.
I need to do it myself.
Why did I get it again? I think it's on this one. Get it? I thought I got it. Makes you think you get it. It's gotta be it. This is the one I always messed up. Well, it's over with. He's dead. I forgot how this one goes. I was wanting to see if I could do it. I don't think it was a fluke, but yeah, when that last one hits like that, it's already over, so we're gonna redo it. We're gonna try it three times. That one's actually tougher than the third one, in my opinion. I'm very thankful though. What? Did I miss it? Yeah.
No, this is my game.
I did it so fast that first time. Alright, we got it. That one is the more I look at it, the more easy it gets. A bit white. Why'd they even get like that? This is close, by the way. Got that one, baby! What? Did I get that? Oh my god. Oh, I thought I got it. Your boy thought he had it for a second. Oh god, I got it. This is it. Dude, I did so much better this time.
You ruined it.
It was my game.
It was mine, not yours.
What are you talking about?
Dude, that was
called out to him. Put an ad in the paper, asking, begging to be tested, to learn. He called out to me and told me to come here. I was finally going to play my game.
You had to come along. Well, dude, if I didn't come along, you was going to die.
Ask for this? Didn't you? Isn't that why you're here?
Jesus. You're just as crazy as him.
We're in an asylum.
He's got a point here.
We're all crazy.
Okay, I'll give you that one. He's like, isn't that why you're here? It's like, no. Okay guys, we are going to go ahead and call it for this part. If you enjoyed the video, please hit the like and subscribe button and come back and see us next time when we take on Jigsaw and we come back with the next part for the playthrough. Thanks again, and we'll see you next time.